be Christ. God looks down and smiles on those, although they are not perfect, those who are running towards Him. And this raises an important practical question. How? What does that look like? What does that look like for us to pursue perfection? Our worship nature within us wants to admire someone and look up to him or her. Hopefully, we all have good role models in life, but even they are imperfect. Obviously, our role model as Christians is Jesus himself. He is our ultimate goal and prize. I wish we knew more about Jesus' life as a teenager, but knowing God, he probably had a good reason to include what he did in the Bible. We've got one verse, and that's Luke chapter 2 verse 52. It is a verse of Jesus' personal Christian development as a teenager and a young adult. This is what it says, "And Jesus increased in wisdom and in years and in divine favor and in human favor." And this is what Jesus did as a youth. He was increasing, he was growing, he was developing. There are four specific areas that Jesus was growing in, and that was in wisdom, in years, in divine favor, and in human favor. And there is that one thing that's for sure. In the same way, we will also not miss out on these four things if we are truly seeking Jesus and moving with His Spirit. These four areas are linked to a Christ culture lifestyle. In Proverbs, we read the emphasis on wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. So how can we grow in wisdom and knowledge? Why should we be nice and take care of ourselves? How can I grow in favor with God? How can I grow in favor with man and still not compromise Christian values? If you're like me, you probably strongly desire to know God's calling and His purpose for your life. Jeremiah 29:11, "For I alone have the plans for you. It's not for destruction, but for prosperity and good health." This definitely is an important verse, and it's one of my favorite verses too. God does have plans and thoughts that He thinks towards each of us. And those are good thoughts. But this is not supposed to stress us out or make us feel anxious. God has got everything in control. Sometimes I think about the fact that Jesus did not begin his ministry until he was 30 years old. Jesus knew. He knew his future and all the plans that God had for his life. But Jesus, as a perfect human, waited until he was 30 years old before he began his ministry. He knew the timing of his Father. If anyone had the right to be youthfully ambitious, Jesus did. So, God has a calling for your life too, but don't let that trap into living in the future. God's calling for you is in the present. He wants you right now. So live your calling now. Your calling is right now. We are called to be ambassadors of Christ. Why are we called that? Why are we called ambassadors? Because our purpose on earth is not to have an education, is not to have a job, is not to have a family. But what is our true purpose? Our true purpose is to spread His word till the ends of the earth, to spread Christ crucified till the ends of the earth. That is our true purpose. And that is why we are called ambassadors of Christ. So pursue Jesus in the present and continue to grow and develop as Jesus did in His youth. Remember the four areas? So the four links or four areas to lead a Christ culture lifestyle is to grow in wisdom. In wisdom by spending time in the Word of God. Number two is to grow in years. Every day, every moment is to trust, serve the Lord, sing praise and worship to the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength. And number three is to grow in divine favor. As you continue and to serve the Lord, to praise and worship the Lord, you grow in divine favor. And simultaneously, you grow in human favor, which is the fourth point. So the four areas is to grow in wisdom, in years, in human, in divine favor and in human favor. So be Christ. God bless you and use you powerfully and mightily for His kingdom and glory. In Jesus' name, Amen.